Hi, welcome to ChemSimplified. I'm Dr. K, and in this video, we are going to go through how to draw structural formula for organic compounds using three examples. Chances are high that when you encounter the structures for organic compounds, they don't always come in the same form. So it'll come in handy if you know how to draw structures using different ways, like expanded, condensed, and bond line or skeletal forms. Before we dive in, let's take a look at how each of the three structural formulas look like. Here's how an expanded structural formula looks like. Notice all the bonds connecting the atoms are shown in the expanded form. This is the closest form drawn from Lewis structure. Next is condensed structural formula. In condensed structural formula, all of the bonds connecting carbons to hydrogens are not shown. Instead, they are condensed into groups of CH3, CH2, and CH. Lastly is the bond line or the skeletal structural formula. In this form, it's basically what the name says, skeletal. It doesn't show out the atoms. For carbons and hydrogens, it only shows the bond connecting them. And if there are other atoms in the molecule, like bromine in our example, then it will be written out. So now that we are familiar with how these three types look like, let's go ahead and try with our first example, drawing from expanded, and we move to condensed, and then from condensed, we draw to bond line. So let's start with our first example. It's an alkyl halide. Don't worry about it if you're not able to classify the compound at this point. I'll put a link to the introduction to the organic compound on the top right of this video. So before we begin drawing from expanded to condensed, it'll be a good idea to start numbering our compound, our parent chain, which is basically the longest chain that you can count from one end to the other continuously. And whatever that is not on the chain that's attached to the chain, those are the substituent. So let me demonstrate. So if we look at our expanded structure right now, I can label from one end to the other like this. And whatever that's not on the carbon, like for example, bromine and CH3, these would be our substituents. So right now in our structure, we have bromine attached to carbon 1, CH3 attached to carbon 4. Don't worry about it too much in terms of numbering unless you need to know how to name the nomenclature. And in that case, I will post related videos in the description box below. So based on our expanded structure, we have 5 carbon and bromine on carbon 1 and CH3 group on carbon 4. So in the condensed structure, what we're going to do is basically just condense up all the CH groups. So it will look like this. So notice Br is still connected to carbon 1 and CH3 is connected to carbon 4, and the rest of it, we just don't show out the vertical bonds like the carbon and the hydrogen bonds. Instead, we only show the carbon and carbon bonds. And sometimes you notice that the bonds between the carbon and carbon are not shown, and that is fine as well. So it may look something like this. And this is still fine because bromine is still attached to the first carbon and CH3 is still attached to the carbon 4. And sometimes you may also find that when it's condensed further, the CH3 on carbon 4 is not drawn out. It will just be written as part of the formula and it will look like this. So bromine on carbon 1, that's fine. The CH3 is written squashed between carbon 3 and carbon 4. And that is fine as well. So condensed form, there are several ways of drawing it out depending on your preference. And if you want to show the bonds between the carbon, that would be the first example. If you want to take out the bonds between the carbon, that would be the second example. If you want to take out all the bonds between the carbons and not showing how the substituent is connected, you can embed it in between the atoms and show it in the third example. If that's a little bit too difficult for you, then stick with the first or the second way of drawing condensed form. Now we move on to bond line or skeletal structure. So we have 5 carbon, we'll number it 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and bromine on the first carbon, CH3 on the fourth carbon. And that's how it looks like. Very clean, very simple, very straightforward. So every point in our skeletal structure represents a carbon and the corresponding number of hydrogens. So we know that carbon forms four bonds. So for example, if we look at our first carbon in the skeletal structure, there are two bonds, one to bromine and one to carbon number two. So from that structure, we know that carbon one should have two hydrogens. And if we refer to the expanded or the condensed form, we can see that carbon number one has two hydrogens. And now we move on to, like, for example, carbon five. So if you look at carbon five in the skeletal structure only has one bond. So that means carbon is supposed to have four bonds. So four minus one will give us three. So carbon five will have three hydrogens attached to it. So it's a CH3. Make sense? So this is how the structures look like without all the circling and the numbering. So expanded form, moving into condensed, it's cleaned up a little bit. We don't show that many bonds. We group our CH groups. Condensed, moving to bond line or skeletal, we clean it up even further. So we don't even write out carbons and hydrogens, and we only show the bonds between carbons to carbon. No bonds, carbon to hydrogens are shown. Okay, feeling good? Let's try our second example. So this is our expanded structure. This is an alkene. So in our structure, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Five carbons again. There are something a little bit different here. There's a double bond between carbon 2 and carbon 3. And also there's that same CH3 group on carbon 4. Now we're going to move on to a condensed structure. So like we've already went through with the first example, condensed structure means we will just not show the carbon-hydrogen bond. Instead, we are just going to group it up together. So let's start off by drawing out the C-C double bond between carbon 2 and carbon 3. If you notice, because of the double bond, carbon 2 only has two other bonds attached to it. Same goes to carbon 3. So that's why I have these two bonds sticking up and down on carbon 2 and carbon 3. Now let's fill out the bonds. So carbon 2, there are two groups attached to it. One is carbon 1, which has three hydrogens. So I group it up as CH3. That's carbon 1. The other group attached to carbon 2, aside from CH3, is a hydrogen. Okay? Now let's look at carbon 3. Carbon 3, there are two groups attached to it. One is a hydrogen, and the other one is carbon 4. And since carbon 4 has hydrogen and then a CH3 and another CH3 group attached to it, I just went ahead and condensed up the CH. So I wrote it as a CH for carbon 4. And then carbon 4 is connected to basically two CH3 groups. So the first CH3 group is our carbon 5. And the other CH3 group is our substituent. Okay? Alright. So now we move to skeletal structure. So skeletal structure, the first thing we do is we draw out the skeleton. So we have a skeleton of 5 carbon, which means we will do a zigzag containing 5 points. So if you notice, I have 5 points here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And between our carbon 2 and 3, there should be another line, 2 lines total, to represent a double bond, because right now everything is single bonded. So I'm going to put in a double bond between carbon 2 and carbon 3. So there we go. So now we have a double bond between C2 and C3. And now we need to stick in our CH3 group, and that's at carbon 4. That's our CH3 at carbon number 4. Okay, moving on to our third example. This is a carboxylic acid. So we only have 4 carbons in this example. C double bond O is on the first carbon. OH is also on the first carbon. So COOH, C double bond OOH, can be shortened or condensed to look like this, COOH. And then we're going to put in our second carbon, which is CH2, third carbon, which is also CH2, and the fourth carbon, which is CH3. And that's it. Pretty easy, right? Okay, moving on to bond line or skeletal. So this is pretty easy as well. Same like what we did for the second example. We count how many carbons we have in our skeleton. And in this case, we have four carbons. So I'm going to draw a zigzag containing four points like this. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. Now, on the first carbon, I am going to attach my C double bond O. And then I'm going to attach my OH. And that's it. So we're all done. We went through three different types of structural formula: expanded, condensed, and skeletal. So which structural formula do you like the most? Do comment below, as I would love to hear from you. Do subscribe if you find this video helpful and click on that bell icon so you get notified on new videos. For more info, please head over to ChemSimplified.com. You will find a blog post related to this video. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.